Oh.
That is good. Let's take a look.
At the bin site. You guys want to see what we've been doing? Check this out.
Is that pretty cool or what?
24,000 bushels right here. This one, on the other hand, we're just gonna grow until we run out of grain, which should be another 25,000 bushels. And we have a tarp ready to go on top of that one too. I misspoke earlier in one of the videos. These are not grain bags, they're tarps that are set up to be cones on top of grain piles. A lot of people have asked, well, what do you do about rodents and mold? Well, we're in a dry environment here and we've had a grain pile sit almost 6-7 months on the ground and haven't had hardly any mold or anything. A little bit of spoilage right around the bottom, but if you figure the percentage out on 20,000 bushels and you spoil just a little bit around the bottom, it's like less than a percent. You don't even get docked. So it's really not a problem. Sometimes your grain bins have more than that. Rodents, there could be a little bit of mice that get in there. They're not gonna do anything to it though. I mean, they can't hurt. There's so much grain there and they scatter off. Yeah, we don't want rodents in there, but that's just how it is. Grain bins get rodents too. An unfortunate fact about storing food is animals find a way to get to it no matter where you put it. And we might be able to reuse these bags next year. We'll see if they hold up in the wind in the winter. They might get ripped apart, but if they don't, we'll use them again maybe. Or we'll just put two 50,000 bushel bins right here, huh? You like that? I like that too. Again, love that truck. But they just moved to another field, so I'm gonna go drive down there and chase them. This road. This is where you get a perspective of what a 45-foot header does. Look how wide that is. I couldn't imagine what my grandpa would think right now. He would just, I think he'd be pretty ecstatic, honestly. So what we're doing here is he went ahead and he's turned around because the field's too long. This field's over 2 miles long, and he's not gonna make it to the end and turn around and come back before he's full. So to get the auger on the right side, he turned around and is cutting back the other way. And I will pull underneath his auger, and he can dump on me while the other combine comes at me. This is gonna be kind of fun. Just tore my air cleaner off. Not your fault, it's just the way the dip was.
That is good. Let's take a look.
That spout on these 8230s hangs down pretty low. Looks like it took the beacon light. Messed that up. That's too bad. We'll fix it, but this isn't my tractor. I don't like doing this kind of stuff to it. He was on a slope here. The combine was tilted a little bit to the side. That's important, we want that. I don't wanna lose that. I think that's all that fell. My beacon broke off, but this I'll be able to put back on. All right, let's go get that combine dumped and I'll take care of it later. Sorry, Torgersons, we'll make it right. Well, for future reference, I'm gonna be careful when the combine's tipping like that. That's the first time that's happened. Fortunately, they make that spout right there nice and flexible. So it didn't do anything to the auger. It just pulled off that cover to the top of the air cleaner, which is just basically hose clamped on. But I'm gonna check out that beacon up there. It looked like it pulled the whole housing off, so I might have broke the plastic housing on it. Well, remember when I said I was gonna not fill that truck really full? I just put 1,300 bushels on it. That's the most I think we've ever put on that truck before. Hopefully it doesn't break in half. Debco, I guess we're putting your trailer through its paces. On the bright side, it doesn't have to go on any roads that are regulated for weight limit, so I can load it that full here. Because we're out here in, you know, our country roads on our farm. So, and it's only going like 2 miles. But if that were going down a legal road, I would not have put that much weight on. Beautiful sky tonight. Well, there was a little bit more clouds right there. It lit up even more, but I'm liking it. It's a good harvest sunset. We take a quick look at our U-Harvest monitor over here. It's nighttime now, so I can actually see what's on the screen. A lot of glare during the day. I've got 68,400 pounds on the cart right now, which makes up, according to this bar, 76.3% of its total capacity. My hitch weight right now is 13.7% on the hitch side, which is good. We want a positive weight on the hitch. If it goes this way, that means it's aft. That means the cart, if the tractor's on this end and the cart's on this end, the cart is wanting the tip backwards, too much weight in the back. So I want positive weight on the hitch to keep the tongue down so it's not banging around. So that's good there. So I've got a pretty even load across this thing. It's pretty much almost perfectly balanced. So right here, I can select what kind of truck I want. So let's just say 9370. And destination, I can put in destination. Current capacity is 1200, let's just say. So I can see now how much weight I put on that truck if I use this screen. But since I know I can fit all this on that truck, I'm just gonna use this screen, and then it'll give me my moisture percent and what the load is when I'm done. So here's Brad right here, he's pulling in, and we'll take care of business. There we go. I got 0 bushels of weight in the truck. 12.9% was the moisture, and I offloaded 1145 bushels onto him. And there he goes. We're moving right along. Here's my all the trucks that I've unloaded on over the last several dumps. So you can see them all here. A lot of them 1,000 bushels, some of them 1,100, some of them 900. It all depends what I've done. A couple times, if you fill a truck twice, like say I didn't have enough to fill a truck, so I had to come back and get some more, then it'll leave like a 300 bushel or whatever. So really neat system. I'm really enjoying this U-Harvest interface, this Raven system. It's honestly awesome. So, recommend it.
I'm in the Big Bud 5 1/4 series 2, and I started thinking I should take it over, hook it up to the plow, and get ready to rip some ground. We had some horse manure on the ground that needs to be spread in, or tilled in, I should say, and there's enough guys with the combines, grain cart, and trucks that I can do this right now. It's either do it now or do it after harvest, but we kind of want to relax or try to get some stuff caught up, so I thought, well, I might as well do this now. So Brad or Wiggles is going to help me with it, so stay tuned. I got the family again. Hi, Taryn. We got Taryn, Roscoe, and Love.
Yeah, oh, it's Love.
Sarah. Oh, it's Love. So yeah, we're sitting in the Big Bud, 5 1/4.
Hi.
You gonna say hi? Can you wave? There you go.
You gonna wave?
Can I have a high five?
Pound it.
So for those that don't know, my lovely wife here is the one that created the Welker Farms logo, like on my hat. She also created the Leg Arms logo, and she has done a couple other things as well. So if you guys are ever interested in having some logos done, you should contact Design Beast.
Designbeastcreative.com.
There we go. I got her to talk. If you guys are interested, she does fantastic work, and she somehow finds time with kids.
Somehow. It's magical.
It's magical. Thank you. Wiggles and I are taking the 9370 to town because we don't have enough storage, but we still have maybe 15 to 20,000 bushels that's got to go somewhere. Let's go to the grain elevator.
Right.
Pretty neat system, but they've got a big bit here that's probably about 1,200 bushels they can take or so, and it's pretty amazing. Guys, I am blown away by the test weight on our wheat right now. That field is 63 pounds, so one bushel is 60 pounds, so this is actually a little bit more than a bushel. And for 4.5 inches of rainfall, I'm amazed that we're even getting that. I figured we'd be getting like 54, 52 pounds a bushel, but it's just amazing. And then the moisture, that's about 12.2, so it's about right. Protein is 12.7. I was expecting the protein to be a little higher, but that's not bad for the considering on everything. But guys, we're just blown away and taken back, and it's only by the grace of God that He's given us what He's given us, and we're just more than thankful. More blessings. That's awesome.
My cue. Let's fill a combine up with diesel. Moving right along, things are going good. We're knocking the acres out quick. Just had lunch break, it was awesome. Not many more of those left, so gotta eat them up while we can. Eat them up. Now we're making good progress. I'm still loving this girl. Quad track's pretty fun. Well, this will fill me, and I'm gonna run back to the truck, offload about 950 bushels in the truck or so. That should be about legal weight. There, and take that to town, and then I'll have a little bit left in the cart, and then I'll keep chasing combines, and then another truck will come, and then I'll offload onto that too. I love these scales. This U-Harvest scale system is just awesome, really nice. There we go, just finished the field. What do you want? I know, auto guidance took control, yeah. Perfect. Okay, we're on to the next field. I might as well just take the weight off these combines since I've got this big old thing driving around. No reason to have the combines hauling weight around when I can do it. So I'll run this down to the truck, fill it up, send it on its way, and we'll move to the next field. So if somehow we could get a hold of one of these transmissions, there's a chance we could get a big bud set up with a PTO shaft. I'd have to see how they run that PTO across the top of the rear axle. But there's a chance we could get it to work. We just need that transmission to have an output PTO shaft on it. We'll see what we can do. Oh, dinner time. All right, back to driving. Best part about a quad track, they fit down a two-track road. Kind of. A little wider. Pretty close. getting late and we're getting close to being done with this field. This field's actually done very well, surprisingly. I bet it's probably an average at least 40 bushels an acre. Some of our best spring wheat on the farm. Amazing, absolutely amazing. This was seeded a lot later, but this ground is just that much more forgiving. So I'm keeping up with the combines, but if I had three combines out here, it'd be a little bit of a mad dash. These two is keeping this cart busy. But that's it's good. So we'll probably shut down here not long and start tomorrow. Good stuff. Well, everybody, appreciate you watching the channel. Thank you for being a part of this Harvest 19. This has been an exciting year for us. It's definitely a gloomy farming year as far as actual making money, but the joy of farming, the thrill of being out here running machines like this, experiencing nature at its best. I mean, this is just, this land is beautiful and it's fun. So thanks for being a part of this. Like, subscribe, and stay tuned for the next video because there's more coming. So God bless, guys. We'll catch you later.